hundreds of performers. 6. Semi-finals. Singers, contortionists, dancers. Six judges, 100 day head vouchers, the winning prize. Who will win? You decide.
Bestie and your bestie sit down by the fire. Your bestie says she want parties, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now. Aiko ane, chucky morphina anane, chucky morphina ane. Start my truck, let's all jump in. Here we go together. Nice cool breeze with big palm trees. I tell you life don't get no better. Talking about hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now. Aiko ane, chucky morphina anane, chucky morphina ane. I tell you mama ngwele, step on the dancing floor. Hips be winding, detail rewinding, take it to the island way. Hey yo baby mama, put on your dancing shoes. One drop it, pop it, blow now, take you to the max now. Jam in this small jam way, jam in this small jam way. My bestie and your bestie, dancing by the fire. Your bestie says you want party, so can we make this place go higher? Talking about hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now. Aiko ane, chucky morphina anane, chucky morphina ane.
Let me take it from here. Salaman girls straight up, right hoochie mama. Make me party non-stop in a island banda. Swing those hips and back it up to me ragga. A dance for party ladies with a doggy doggy. I'm drumming island reggae, rapping blue, green and yellow. Me tapping and me beat, make a slow wine for me baby. Speakers pumping, people jumping. We drumming the island way.
Shout out to the good time crew all across the islands. Grab your shoes, let me 2x2, and now we shine it bright like diamonds. Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
Aiko ane, chucky morphina anane, chucky morphina ane.
Yes, one drop it, drop it low now, take it to the max now. Drum in the small time way, wind it.
Wind up, go down, push your body back, wide.
We go
left, left, we go right, right. Turn it around and forward.
Wind and go down again.
Wind up, go down. Twist your body backward.
Twist it back.
We go left, left, we go right, right. Turn it around and forward.
My bestie and your bestie dancing by the fire. Your bestie says you want party, so can we make this place go higher? Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
Aiko ane, chucky morphina anane, chucky morphina ane.
welcome to our virtual Hillpark's Got Talent. Now, normally, we would be stuck in the Assembly Hall, and you'd all be there, but today, I've been able to come and see you. I know, I've got a phone in my hand, but do you know why? Did you see all that wonderful dancing? I did. I'm waiting on a phone call from Strictly, just in case. Because you never know, they might want us on a Saturday afternoon, or they might not. Who knows? Anyway, how are you doing? Now, I've got to say a huge big thank you to our technicians and to Apple Cable. Because you can not only see me, I can see you. How you doing, Mrs. Waugh? Give us a wave! You, Miss Hammond, how's that first year class doing? Oh, look at that class there with Mrs. Ross. I think that's third year. Oh, and look at y'all. You've got your Christmas jumpers on like me. Well, this Christmas, we're almost at the end of the season and we're going to have a fantastic show this afternoon. And I want to hear as much noise from everyone. So after three, I'm going to listen and watch to see who takes place. Did you enjoy the dancing? One, two, three. Now, come on, there's somebody in Mr. Fisher's class. Come on, Mr. Fisher, get them on. Did you enjoy the dancing? Excellent, excellent indeed. Well, can I say to you, we have an amazing show this afternoon, and you are really going to enjoy yourselves. You'll see me in different Christmas jumpers to get us into the mood, and I'm really pleased that some of you have got your Christmas jumpers on. But for the moment, we've got a show, we've got the time, but what do we need most of all? Which is, of course, our Hillpark talent judges. So can I welcome our six judges right at this minute? Give them a huge big round of applause.
Hold on a minute, is this thing on or what? Where is that wee bam?
Of the Hillpark's Got Talent show. I am your queen and I am here to be a judge. I was just out there on the horses, but I am here to wish you all the very best.
Charles, get the horses, give me up.
Oh, wonderful judges. But who are they? What are they like? What are they bringing to our panel? Well, our first judge, smooth talking, silky tongue, known throughout the nation as a fashion icon, Mr. Moran. We'd like to know, how have you dealt with the pressure? And how do you think our young people are going to deal with the pressure of being part of this wonderful production?
Well, Dermot, as some of you may know, I was lucky enough to go to Glasgow University. And at Glasgow University, they teach you all about resilience. Resilience. That's when the judges' comments, I think some of them may be a little harsh. You need to learn how not to take it personally.
Okay, our second judge tonight, we're going to move away from the cloisters of university into a more upbeat and modern personality. Champagne, an unusual name, but nevertheless, champagne, we think of it's sweet, it's refined, it pours beautifully. We're wondering, are you going to pour beautifully tonight as you speak to the pupils and encourage them?
I didn't understand a word of that. I'm actually not sure what I'm even doing here, to be totally honest. Don't know. What?
Good evening. Our third judge is Wee Skeggsy, and I'd like to ask him, what is it like living in Greece?
What are you talking about, you mad rocket?
There's a wee problem in the autocue. I meant to say, what's it like living in curfew? Because, of course, we know that you bring a notoriety almost as international, right the way to Pollock Shields. What are you bringing to the panel tonight, Wee Skeggsy?
I tell you what I'm bringing. I'm no following the rules. See the curfew? This tag gets ripped off every night. Me and Wee Champagne belt out all the time. I'll be bringing honesty, honesty, honesty right to the core. Nae mucking about for HPYT. Have that in your chips.
Moving along quickly then, we come to somebody who's known for her deceit, her cunning, an absolutely evil person. The nation is asking tonight, Cruella de Vil, why are you here? Should you be here? What are you bringing to our young people?
What am I doing here? Well, darling, I can spot a fake a mile away, so my job is to see if there's any real talent in amongst these mongrels.
Your Majesty, it is so good to see you tonight. And to know that you've been able to come away from the crown that we're all watching. Any idea of what's happening in the next few episodes? No, it's not for tonight. Your Majesty, you bring a sense of wealth. You bring a sense of well-being. What are you bringing to our young people tonight?
Well, as you know, I have a very large family myself, very well known around the globe. And my children, although not many people know it, have often played musical instruments and showed varied talents, Charles. And of course, then there's the wonderful Princess Anne and Princess Margaret, and of course, Mama and Papa. They were all such great comedians. So variety is in our life. I'm here to judge the talent of all the peasants, our pupils. Spill the tea. Don't spill the tea.
The final judge this evening needs no introduction. The ruddy complexion, the fuller figure, the smell of icing and cinnamon. It can only be one person. It's Mother Christmas. The nation has been asking two things. One, what is your first name? And secondly, what are you looking for in our pupils?
Well, my name's Mary, Merry Christmas, obviously, and I didn't go to Glasgow University, I went to Paisley Uni, and see, me, I'm just trying to get away from my man, because he is one lazy, lazy, lazy article, and do you know what, all he does is work one night a year, and it's all about him, the usual. Well, I'm just here to tell you, it's about me the night, right, so I just can't wait to be entertained.
A huge big thank you then to the judges. They're going to have a really difficult time tonight. They're helped by myself, but you know, they're also helped by two others who I'm going to introduce in a minute or two. Hillpark is great. Do you know why? We try to get kids jobs. We try to support them. And two wee guys came along and said they wanted to be the compere. They wanted to be the host. So what have we done? We have given them work experience. So in our room next door, they're actually just getting ready, preparing to meet the guests, to meet the contestants, and we're just going to pop along just now.
Good afternoon, I'm Matthew.
And I'm Jack.
And together we are
Matthew and Jack.
You do wonder what we're doing here.
I don't know, Jack. What are we doing?
The most important job of the show, that's all.
What do you mean, Jack?
Get to interview all the performers.
The Aspro, that's a belter of a job.
I wonder who's up first.
Hi, my name's Lewis Henderson. I'm in Pentland Group and I got through because I'm good at skills.
Then I got and I was a cameraman.
So Lewis, what age did you start your scootering?
I've been scootering for 6 years.
How long have you done your camera business?
Just a few days, that's all.
it called The Little Red Off Roller Cup. This is called The Triple Dribble.
This is called the Easy Sniper Shot.
This is called the Little Rodeo Shot.
Down in the valley, oh, I am a vision.
This is called the Fakie.
If anybody asks you who I am.
The Trouble.
Hand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm not starving us.
Oh, thank you very much, boys. Now, what's going to happen tonight, so that everybody's quite clear, is if I went to every single judge after every single act, we'd be here until after Christmas. And we don't want that, do we? Absolutely not. So what I'm going to do tonight is I'm going to cut to two judges after every act, let them give their comments, and then we'll get the votes later on. Okay, I actually believe, Mr. Moran, that this was a judge's choice. So I'm looking to ask yourself, what did you think of the act tonight? What drew you? What's your comments?
Well, Dick, when I saw these two athletes, I thought they could definitely get into Glasgow University. And tonight, the talent on the basketball court, phenomenal, phenomenal. I have no doubt these two will go all the way.
Thank you very much. Well, Cruella, we're going to come to you. Do you think these boys are the next stars of the Harlem Globetrotters?
Well, what do you think? Because I know what I think. Absolutely not. Where was the scooter? Scootering for all his life, there wasn't a scooter in sight. The ball, I tell you what you'd be best doing with the ball. Give it to the puppies and they will burst it.
We're delighted to say that we're here with Megan Ray. Right, let's get serious. Megan, have you ever wrote your own song?
Yes, I had to write my own songs for music. That's class, Megan. Now, if you were a vegetable, what vegetable would you be? I think I'd be a beetroot, because I'm always bright red.
Oh,
a beautiful song indeed. So melodic, so, oh, just so nice. Champagne, did it pop your cork?
Shut up, Skeggs, I'm no greeting. One word, absolute quality.
Haunting melody really transported me back to a different time. Wee Skeggsy, were you transported back to a different time?
I tell you what, Megan, Ray, I was expecting a ray of sunshine, a ray of hope. That was miserable. I tell you what, Megan, see if you were in the HPYT, you'd be getting booted right out. I'm wanting techno, I'm wanting MC, I'm wanting the heavy tunes pumping. I was bored out my skull.
And now we have Taylor Burrows, the guitarist, here with us today.
Put more energy into that, Matthew.
Be quiet, Jack. Okay, Taylor, how many tries did it take you to get that song looking perfect?
Right, well, obviously I'd mess up a part and had to restart it, so I think maybe I did it around over five at least.
Taylor, have you ever cut your hair before?
Well, obviously not recently, I guess, but yeah.
Mum, you're used to legendary guitarists standing in your roof, playing to the whole nation during your centenary celebrations. Yes. How do you think Taylor did tonight?
My mind is blown. My mind is blown. First of all, when I heard you plucking those guitar strings, all I wanted to do was jump back to my teenage years and throw myself into the mosh pit. Secondly, and a lot of people don't know that about me, secondly, as a nod to me, you played Queen, and you do have the hair of Brian May, if I do say. And then third, I just wanted to get up and shake my royal shimmy. Let me tell you something now, young man. I would love you to play at a royal wedding, and hopefully it would break the curse of having them all end in divorce.
Merry Christmas. We know that you're a bit of a Mother Christmas figure, but really you're a rock chick. What did you get from our player tonight?
Well, I love a bit of heavy metal, because I just love to just rock my socks off on a Saturday night. So anyway, I just absolutely love heavy metal, and I just, because rocking around the Christmas tree, I think it's all more than that.
Matthew, who are you here with today?
Today we're here with Mel.
Mel Cassidy! Sorry, I'm too excited.
That's fine, Jack. So Mel, how many tries did it take you to get your routine looking perfect?
One.
It only took one. Well done. I couldn't do it in only one. Could you, Jack?
No, that's impressive. Couldn't do that. Mel, do you have a favourite food?
Yeah.
Pizza. I like pizza too. Pizza's nice.
Yeah, it is.
Do you have a favourite type of pizza?
I like a lime.
I like a lime.
So, thank you, Mel, for chatting with us today.
Yeah. I hope you do well in the finals.
Okay.
Mischief makery. I wonder how many of you have got sore toes, because I can honestly say that young lady almost crushed my toes twice. But tonight, we're not going to crush her, are we, Champagne? What do you think of our performance?
Well, having seen her in the semi-final, I'd have her in my young team in a minute. I mean, she's knocking down bams left, right and centre, especially that last idiot that she shoved into the pool. That's the winner for me.
Mr. Moran, you come from a different perspective, from the lofty heights of university. Was there much mischief-making going on? And what did you think of our young girl in Hot Wheels?
Well, Davina, coming from the perspective of risk assessment, I feel that there may be some questions asked, but that's not what we're here for. The talent on display, I think Mel could get into Glasgow University dramatic course in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. And her hair, darling, fabulous. Fabulous hair.
Now we're here with Alex. How long have you been playing the piano?
Just about 10 years now.
What's your favourite ice cream flavour?
My favourite ice cream flavour is... chocolate, obviously.
Chocolate? That's dead boring, Matthew. What's your favourite type of ice cream?
I like vanilla ice cream. I know it's boring, but what do you like?
In the boring part, but the, like, the flavour, you should change it up. It's actually raspberry ripple. That's my favourite.
Thank you.
I suppose after all that music from Alex or Alexandrina, there's only one judge that we can go to, and of course that's Merry Christmas. You must have felt at home, jingle bells and all that music. What did you feel when Alexandrina was playing tonight?
I just felt fabulous. I just thought, Jingle Bell Rock, is that for me? Is that just specifically for me?
Music, they say, calms the savage beast. Well, we've got certainly only got one beast today, and that's Miss Cruella de Vil. Miss de Vil, has your beast been calmed by that beautiful music we heard tonight?
Well, it might be beautiful to you, but to me, it is ghastly. Can't we give the Christmas songs a rest?
Matthew Lyle, Freddie Welsh,
the comedy act of the century.
What's your favourite joke? Like the one that you said, like in the video.
What pie can fly?
I don't know.
A magpie.
So what's your favourite time of day?
Well, obviously not the noon.
My name is Matthew Lyle, one half of the comedy acts of the century. Thanks for putting us through to the final.
I'm Freddie Welsh, the other half of the comedy acts of the century. Cheers for the votes.
And for the final, get ready for some Christmas themed jokes.
And some Christmas themed costumes.
Hello, it is me, Santa Claus. It's really just me, Matthew. And for my first Christmas joke, why does Santa have so many gardens? You don't know, so he can ho ho ho.
Hello there, and I'm Mrs. Claus. Do you want to know a joke? So, what did Santa do when he went speed dating? You don't know. He pulled a cracker. Me, because I'm gorgeous.
Here's another joke, a singing joke. What do you get when you cross a snowman with a vampire? You didn't know, frostbite. Ho, 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 ho.
Do you like my little cracker joke? The cracker joke says, How does Darth Vader like his turkey? Him, do you get the answer? A little in the dark side. I know, it was rubbish. Ooh. Nothing like Freddie and Matthew there with their jokes and their Christmas spirit. Let's go to the guy that put them through, the judge's choice.
Do you know what? Matthew and Freddie are in my team, man, the HPYC, and they are my muckers, so that was heavy brilliant. I was hysterically laughing so much, my moustache fell off my face, man. It was heavy brilliant. I can't wait to see more of those muckers, but I tell you something, they need to sort the outfits. If they're cutting about with my team, ruin the scheme, then they need to get their outfits off and get their actual kappa clobber right back on there. Well done, boys. Keep it up.
Some really good comments there from wee Skeggsy, but let's move away from the estate over to Buckingham Palace, and we're going to ask Her Majesty what she thought. Now, we're told there's a couple of jokers in that place, but let's see what the Queen has to say about her two boys there.
Oh, there are some jokers in the palace. We have jesters galore, as I'm sure you have seen over the years. Let me just give my feedback to little Weddy Frelsch and Lathew Mile. I have three letters for you, one word. Lol. Yes, I'm down with the young people and I have my finger on the pulse. I loved the costumes, darlings, but I must say, was it Mrs. Claus? I do believe maybe you've been rummaging through my wardrobe, because I recognize that cardigan. Perhaps the people outside the palace with the big hats have not been looking after my gaff as much as they should have. There you go, gaff, got that word from you. But I loved it. I thought it was hilarious. The next time that I go to Bellamore, you are welcome to come and join me for the lols.
Now, we're here with Caleb Reed.
So Caleb, how long have you been playing the flute?
I played the flute for 6 years.
You play the flute for your monstros?
I don't know, but I can try.
Caleb there, wonderful playing. His first tune, I hope you recognised it, was Joy to the World. We're going to go to Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, did that bring you great joy?
That was my judge's choice because oh, Caleb, my desk is a mess without you, son. And I tell you what, it's amazing to hear you blowing hot air doing that flute. And I tell you what, it was such a beautiful sound that came out, no, like my husband when he blows a lot of hot air, do you know what I mean? So I just thought you were amazing.
Thank you, Merry Christmas. A lot of hot air you're saying. I wonder if Champagne's going to agree. Champagne, were you tickled at all by that beautiful sound?
Scared you were meant to make me up?
I fell asleep and all.
That went on for a bit, didn't it? Before I fell asleep, I wrote one word. Bored.
We're here with Sarah and Hannah.
What shoe size are you?
I'm a size 6, and I'm also a 6.
Every clip first try.
But it took us 2 full periods to get it perfect.
See after that, I tell you, I'm just sweating watching it. I thought Strictly Come Dancing was good on a Saturday night, but what do you think of these two girls? And of course, I'm asking you folks, because you're going to vote, but I'm also going to ask the judges. And do you know the judge I'm going to go to first? Wee Skeggsy. What did you think of that, sir?
What about the pair of dafties jumping about like idiots, man? What is that all about? I've no got a clue. Tell you what, see if somebody was doing that in my gaff, they'd be getting booted right out the joint, because that's no on. And anyway, what use is that when you're getting chased after the police anyway? You just need to belt it 100 miles an hour, go 90, get away from them. That's it, deal with it. Done with that, man.
I'm really glad that wee Skeggsy there recognised how strong and athletic and agile they were. Did that remind you, Miss Cruella de Vil, of you when you were a young girl?
Back then when I was much younger, I was more interested in fashion than flip-flopping around in a gym hall. What I'll say is that the girls with their TikToks
That's a lot of nonsense, and in fact, what they should be doing is listening to a clock and studying. What a waste of time.
A few minutes ago, Caleb played to his joy to the world, and for many people, Christmas is a really happy time, but not for everyone. This has been a difficult year, and so it's wonderful to see some of the work that you are sitting in the classrooms this afternoon have done. Now, we've got a very special guest, and that special guest is going to show us in the video in a moment or two is Mrs. Collins. Now, the only thing I'm disappointed about is she's not got a tartan skirt on and she's not dancing. But let's cut across to hear what Mrs. Collins is going to tell us. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Hillpark Secondary, and of course, the Hillpark community who have tuned in to Hillpark's Got Talent 2020. I just wanted to share with you the generosity that has been shown by pupils, staff and parents in regards to our Christmas Joy initiative. It's been a pretty tough year for most of us, but for some families it's been particularly hard, and we have tried to put something in place to make Christmas a little bit easier. The Christmases we all enjoy and often take for granted, we want to ensure that everyone within the Hillpark community has a very special Christmas. Now I'm hoping that the Hillpark elves are away for a cup of tea, and then I can give you a sneaky peek at what we've done so far. Shh.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10, it's glistening once again, with candy canes and silver lanes that glow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door.
Now we're here with two members of the Parent Council who are here to help with the Christmas Joy Appeal.
Hi!
Hi!
So what inspired you to do this?
So this year's been really hard for everybody, and we thought it would be a nice way for the school community to come together to help other people out and to start this appeal.
So, what's your favourite part of a Christmas dinner?
I think after dinner's over, I like it when all the kids do the washing up.
Now we are here with Khalil Ahmed.
What made you to decide that you're going to stick to doing Hillpark's Got Talent?
I mean, I just went in it for fun, really.
Thank you.
Khalil was self-taught, so he was telling me. We're going to go to somebody, one of our judges, who was self-taught. And of course, we're going to go to Mr. Moran. Being a self-taught man yourself, what did you think of our pianist?
Well, Dick, when I was at Glasgow University, I had the opportunity to study piano. I studied maths instead, but I had the opportunity to study piano. And I feel that Khalil would fit in very well at Glasgow University with his skills on the piano. Wonderful.
Your Majesty, Buckingham Palace is renowned for the number of concerts, the virtuosos who come to entertain. What do you think of our Khalil?
Oh, thank you, Mr. Dixon. You're right. We do know how to throw a party. Well, young man, let me tell you, I had my eyes closed at the start, and I could have sworn it was little Elton John on the piano, but it was you. It was absolutely splendid, but my favourite part, and please don't interrupt, my favourite part was in the middle, when it was like your upright Yamaha was combined with Saturday Night on the GBX. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Didn't think I knew that one, did you? Fantastic. Elton John will be absolutely livid with jealousy. Cheers to that.
Now we're going to interview Leo Tinland.
Hello.
So, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you like to sing?
8. Leo, how can you hit so high notes, but when I try it, I end up like that?
I honestly have no idea.
Thank you, Leo, for coming here today to speak with us.
Bye for now. It is love we must hold on to, never easy, but we try. Sometimes our happiness is captured, somehow our time and place stand still. Love lives on inside our hearts and always will. Minutes turn to hours, days to years then gone. But when all else has been forgotten, still our song lives on. Maybe some moments weren't so perfect, maybe some memories not so sweet. But we have to know some bad times, or our lives are incomplete. Then, when the shadows overtake us, just when we feel all hope is gone, we'll hear our song and know once more our love lives on. Happiness endure through the darkest of our troubles. Love is beauty, love is pure. Love pays no mind to desolation. It flows like a river through the soul, protects, persists, and perseveres, and makes us whole. Hours, days to years then gone. But when all else has been forgotten, still our song lives on. That's how a moment lasts forever, when our song lives on.
I tell you, I'm old enough to remember another Leo, and that was Leo Sayre, but I don't think he was as cute or adorable as that. I wonder, will the judges agree with me? First of all, we're going to go to wee Skeggsy. Skeggsy, what did you think of Leo's song?
Tell you what, L-Dog, you can be in my MC crew anytime. You are some chanter, son, man. You get yourself down to HPYC, we'll get an MC over that, we'll get a heavy tune bouncing along, me and you muck are writing about it, son. Keep going.
I tell you, as sweet as saccharin. And of course, you know which judge I'm going to go to. The one that's as sour and nasty. Miss Cruella de Vil, what did you think of our beautiful young singer?
As beautiful and cute as a spotless puppy. Absolutely ghastly. The best thing about the performance was the cardigan. And even that would be used as a dog bed. On with the next, please.
Today we are here with Dante Major.
So how long have you been drawing, Dante?
So I started drawing in primary five. Then I started getting better from there, and now I have better drawings now.
Thank you for talking with us, Dante.
Adios, amigos.
Precious when you smile. Yeah. Hit it from the back and drive you wild. Yeah. All I lose myself in those eyes.
Well, I don't know about you, but I feel quite excited introducing Dante to you. Do you know why? I could be introducing the next Banksy. What do you think, Your Majesty? Do you know who Banksy is?
I don't know who Banksy is. I only carry cash. I've never been to the Banksy. Now, here's the thing. Honestly, when I was watching that, I was rather transfixed. I have had my portrait drawn many a time, but you drew some of my favourite things. First of all, a glass of wine, usually a tea. You draw a cliff like the White Cliffs of Dover, and all the optical illusions of my mind was all confused. But just to give you a little insight, normally I end up with something like this. Very dull, I think you would agree. Dante Major, can you see it? No longer are you Dante Major. According to I, your queen, you are Major Dante. Have an honor on me and do me a better picture than this.
Thank you, Your Majesty. We're told a picture paints 1,000 words. What words would you like to tell us, Merry Christmas, about Dante?
Well, Dante, I can tell how important it is that you celebrate your talent. And I will tell you this, the eyes are the windows of your soul. So do you know what? You've got an amazing soul, son. You're going to go straight to heaven. That was amazing. Wonderful. Thank you for sharing your talent with us.
Now we're here with Cara Selvin.
Hi.
What's your favourite type of dance?
I like lyrical.
If you were an animal, what animal would you be? I'd
be a butterfly because I really like the colour of their wings.
Say, Caris, thank you for such an upbeat song, upbeat music, and a real feel-good factor this afternoon. I don't know about MD else, but I really enjoyed it. But let's go to somebody who I have a sneaky feeling may have enjoyed that as well. And first of all, of course, we're going to our bubbly, our sparkling champagne. What do you think?
I would love to be dancing about Darnley Dams with that wee lassie every single Saturday night. Don't get me wrong, the techers could do a wee bit of work, but I'm not sure if we've had a member of the HPYT that's been younger than about, what age is she, 9? You're the first invite.
Well, what can we say about Champagne's words there? Fantastic, bubbly, sweet. My goodness, I've never heard her being so eloquent. But we do have an eloquent judge in our panel, and I'm going to go to him to see what he thought about Caris's dancing today. Mr. Moran, what would you think?
Well, Ryland Clark-Neil, I do have a connection with dancing. I was told when I started Glasgow University that I could be a dancer. Thank you, Mummy. However, I feel that Caris's dancing was just superb, and I'm sure Glasgow University would have her on their dancing programme in a minute. Fantastic dancing.
Well, guys, we've heard from our judges this afternoon, but you know who the real judges are? The ones who know what's really good and really bad? That's you. Not just our Hillpark secondary pupils, but we've got some judges from our primary schools. They've been listening to the acts, they've been watching, they've been taking notes, trying to see who they like, who they don't like. And we're just going to hear from them just now, from our pupils in our associated primary schools. Can you hear them?
Kingston, we hope you win.
Yeah, we hope you win Hillpark Got Talent, because we think you were the best.
You doing Mia?
Hi, I'm Roxy.
Hi, I'm Scarlett.
Today we picked Megan Murray for the talent show. We think that she's really good at doing the guitar, which many people can't do.
And
she's also very good at singing. Yeah, we pick her and we hope she wins.
Hi, I'm Chloe in Gowan Bank in primary school, and I'm in P7, and I would like to vote for Mel Cassidy for like showing who she is and like expressing herself. So yeah, I would like to choose Mel Cassidy for that. So I hope she gets a chance in winning, and yeah, bye.
I want to vote for Alex from Nevis because she was amazing at the piano and was really fast.
I want to vote for Matthew and Freddie doing the comedy because I just love comedy.
Leo! Leo! Went for Cleve!
Welcome back. What did you think of the primary ones there, eh? You know what they say, out of the mouth of babes and angels. You heard what they thought about it. Now, we've had 12 acts, just so you know where we are. We've had 12 acts, we've got 6 acts to go. And I heard that somebody was saying, how are we going to vote? So let me say this to you. And so that I get it correct, I'm putting on the glasses, okay? So listen to this. Very official. All pupils will receive an email with a link to cast their vote electronically after the show. Parents and carers will also receive a group call message and they'll be able to email with this link. The link will be posted in the school Twitter. Now, voting is open from 3:15 today, and all I want to say is good luck to all the rest of the finalists. So let's get on with the show.
Now we have Jonathan. So, what inspired you to do makeup?
I did it for a laugh. It's my sister. She kind of teached me, so then I just started doing it for a troll.
Jonathan, what's your favourite colour to use on your palette?
I like all the colours because it's Jamie Charles, so yeah, I just use everything.
Hey sister, it's just me. Jonathan here, aka Lil Jenna Hardy, and today I'm going to be doing makeup. I'm going to be doing a part 2 makeup. It's going to be looking fabulous, and I just want to say thank you for everyone who voted for me. You're the real G's. I think there's something wrong with my hair. I need to fix that. Let me just do this. Ooh, now I've done my hair. So let me just get right into my face. I think everyone know what I'm going to be putting first. Matte foundation. Let's get right into it. I'm going to be applying dots to my face first, so then after that I can blend it, you know. So I'm just going to do dots like that. Okay, blend it, you know. I'm going to blend it like just dots. Just keep on doing dots. Now I'm just going to use my matte powder for my concealer and my setup powder. Now I'm just going to pat this under my eyes like this. Put bronzer, I'm just gonna dip it, and then I'm gonna put line, and then dip again, and then line. Now I'm just gonna use bronzer in my nose. I'm gonna do line. Now I'm gonna be putting blusher above my
bronzer, so and then I'm just gonna dot here. So I'm gonna be putting highlighter now. I love her. I'm gonna be light the highlighter. I'm just gonna glow. Woo. Next I'm going to be doing my eyebrows, so let me just do that and then I'm going to next I'm going to be doing a cut crease on my eyes, so I'm just going to do that, then do like a line. I'm looking good. Now I'm going to put gold in my eyes, so do that, and then I'm just going to do here. Next I'm going to be doing eyeliner, so yep. Next I'm going to be putting eyelashes. I'm going to be putting this on, so you need to slowly stick it in, boom. Whoa, this is the eyelashes, fake eyelashes, and actual look like a lassie. Next I'm going to be putting lipstick on, and that's not the last thing. The last thing is this, just on, you do that. I just had a wee plastic surgery way better than Kylie Jenner's, so yep. Now it's the big thing. Do you like my dress?
Say about Jonathan, perhaps he's going to be another James Charles YouTuber and make thousands and millions of pounds. But before we do that, Merry Christmas. What did you think of that? Is your makeup as good as his?
Well, unfortunately no, but I did get a few tips, because magnetic lashes all the way, Jonathan. You have actually on point, and that hair, it took me right back to a bit of Purple Rain, because Prince really is my icon, and your hair is magnificent. However, the makeup, do you know one thing that I really, really need to get done, which I haven't got done yet, is a nostril wax. And it's the most magnificent experience, because it literally takes all your hair nostrils away. And it's magnificent, but honestly, those eyes are on point. And I swear, after this COVID, I am going to buy every single thing and do every single thing that you have done. You've taught me so much.
Cruella, we're coming to you. You're somebody that knows a lot about makeup. You're somebody that uses it day in and day out to try and beautify yourself. What did you think about Jonathan?
Darling, you're absolutely right. I have my dearest friend, Charlotte Tilbury, to give me tips anytime I require. Jonathan, do yourself a favour. Sack your sister. She knows nothing about makeup, and her tips for you, darling, are, quite frankly, a shambles. Another point I'd like to make, Jonathan, is that perhaps makeup might not quite be your talent, as you like to express, and maybe you should look for something a little bit different, like joining up the dots on our poster or colouring. Good luck with whatever you choose to do in the future, but makeup certainly shouldn't be your talent.
We're here with Callum Fillington. How did you manage to get all those camera angles? Did you do it yourself, or did you have somebody else to record that?
Well, basically what I did was, to get all the camera angles I needed, I went around the school 5 days in advance with my phone, and I took photographs of every single shot and every location to see if it would look good on film. I left nothing up to chance at all, and every single shot you see in the film was carefully planned ahead of time, extensively. So yeah, that how I got every shot was because I planned almost obsessively.
What kind of music genre are you into?
Well, I'm not really into any specific genre. Just for me, music's just whatever sounds good, I'll like it. But I do have a particular affinity for Western music, or country music, I should say. And yeah, just film scores, even though it's not really a genre, just film scores in general I find to be more interesting than normal music.
Now we are here with Liam McLean.
Can you be so good at those acting skills? I couldn't even do that even if I tried.
I'm not that good, it's more Callum. Callum decided all the shots. He had everything planned out days in advance. He's got a real strong story behind this that he worked out himself, and I was just kind of along for the ride.
Liam, what's your favourite food?
My favourite food? Probably salt and vinegar crisps. Go.
What do you say to that? Didn't expect to see some sort of film noir this evening. What? I don't even know what to say. Skeggsy, what do you think?
What is that all about? I don't understand any of that. It's just... what is that all about? Is it meant to scare me or something? Disney scare a member of HPYT? No chance. That's like watching some sort of Disney cartoon to me. I don't get scared. What is that all about? That's all I've got to say.
Your Majesty, you were someone who actually awarded Alfred Hitchcock, one of the great producer-directors of these types of films, an award. What do you think of Callum's efforts this evening?
Well, I can tell you this, Mr. Dixon. Skeggsy may not have been scared, but I am full of the heebie-jeebies. Let me tell you, when I go back to sleep in the palace tonight, all of the lights will be on and all of the corgis will be beside me. That was utterly engrossing and terrifying. And at the bottom of it all, I must say, both Callum and Liam have an immense talent for acting and filmmaking. I don't know if John Lewis will be on the telephone asking you to make the next Christmas advert, but what a talent. Don't spill your tea. Ooh.
We're here with Hayley.
Hi.
So, how long have you been singing?
Probably since I was a really young age, maybe like 2 or 3.
Who's your favourite Harry Potter character? As I can see, you're a Harry Potter fan by your jumper.
Probably Luna Lovegood.
There was a time when I was alone, nowhere to go and no place to call home. My only friend was the man in the moon, and even sometimes he would go away too. Then one night as I closed my eyes, I saw a shadow flying high. He came to me with the sweetest smile, told me he wanted to talk for a while. He said, Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. And ever since that day, I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run on, lost boy, they say to me, away from a low reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. He sprinkled me in pixie dust and told me to believe in him and believe in me. Together we will fly away in a cloud of green to your beautiful destiny. As we soared above the town that never loved me, I realized I finally had a family. Soon enough we reached Neverland. Peacefully my feet hit the sand. And ever since that day, I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free.
Thank you. Now, before we move to the judges, I have to say we've had a big problem this evening. Our judges, you'll see in a moment or two, Mr. Moran had an accident from on the way here tonight and he's had to take off his suit jacket. Luckily, I was able to give him one of my old Christmas jumpers. So just in case when we go to Mr. Moran, you actually think he's auditioning for Still Game. He's not. He's still our fashionista, even though he doesn't look it tonight. Thank you.
Well, Tess Daly, I'll have you know that this is Sparks and Mensa's finest. Shut up. So, at Glasgow University, as I have said before, I had the opportunity to sing with Ruth B, who created that song. Of course, I sang with her on the radio, but I feel that you did that wonderfully. And if they don't vote for you... Shut up, Skeggsy. If they don't vote for you, they are just crazy.
Champagne, you were like an over-fizz bottle there, wanting to come in with comments with Mr. Moran. What's going on tonight?
I don't know what that Mr. Moran's talking about. He doesn't know whether it's New York or New Year in that jumper. Oh my God, embarrassing, mate. Who are we even talking about anymore? All these acts are all the same. I'm not even sure.
Now, we're here with Kingston.
Hey, oh my G, thanks for having me in it, blood.
Kingston, let's forget the interview. We're going outside to make a rap.
Kingston, yeah? You think you're funny? Shut up, mate. You have no money.
Yeah, man. This isn't your time. Get out, fam. You're not ready for grime.
Hey, yo, fam. Your bars are weak. Come here, you'll get slapped the next week.
Listen, man. I only flame OGs only. Yeah, after this, you're gonna be mad lonely.
You heard about coronavirus, you saw on the news and that.
What's that?
Changing our lives, innit? Oh, better yeah. Make a diss track on it.
Yo, this track.
Get the accent off.
No.
Right, we're staying with the accent then. Yeah, so this our diss track on it.
Yo, let's get it.
Coronavirus, make people sick. In lockdown, yeah, we still lit. Coronavirus, I'm here for the crown. In this talent show, best know I ain't backing down. Coronavirus got us on lockdown. Vaccine about to get it shut down. Coronavirus make people sick. Coronavirus about to catch this kick. As I said, I'm here for the crowd. Yeah, Corona ain't funny, but Corona's still a clown. I'm just trying to see my friends, but I need to isolate. I'm just trying to have a chat, but I need a mask on my face. Coronavirus about to know its place. It don't belong here or out of space. Coronavirus must have been misplaced. I think God must have made a mistake. Coronavirus make people sick. In lockdown, yeah, we still lit. Coronavirus, I'm here for the crown. In this talent show, best know I ain't backing down. Coronavirus got us on lockdown. Vaccine about to get it shut down. Coronavirus make people sick. Coronavirus by the catch of this king. Corona, coronavirus, coronavirus, corona, corona, coronavirus, coronavirus. It is whack, yeah. Corona is trash, yeah. Corona better get bashed, yeah. I ain't trying to be brushed, yeah. Really thinking I might give it away. Corona ain't ruining Christmas, know what I say. I've been hoping Christmas. Corona ain't here to stay. Hoping it's eradicated and the people say yay. I'm hoping that we'll get to open presents, say hooray. But the presence of the present in the present fading away. Fading away. Coronavirus, maybe. In lockdown, there is coronavirus. I'm here for the crown. And this talent show, best know I ain't backing down. Coronavirus got us on lockdown. Vaccine, about to get it shut down. Coronavirus make people sick. Coronavirus, about to catch its kick. Yeah, Corona, Corona, Coronavirus, Coronavirus, Corona, Corona, Coronavirus, Coronavirus. This a measure for Corona, yeah? You think you're boss man, innit? You think gonna make us coughing now? You think gonna spread across our town, our country? We ain't gonna allow that, fam. Get the hell out of here, fam. UK for life, innit, youths?
Roast me.
I wonder if Kingston is going to be the next Dizzy Rascal. I wonder. Skeggsy, you've not had a good night tonight. You've slagged off everybody. You've hated this. You've put that down. What do you think about our Kingston?
Well, you know what? I'm normally into a bit of MC over a GBX, a bit of Disco Land and all that nonsense, but I tell you what, I was kind of impressed with that nonsense, and I liked the video and all that, but I'm telling you, Kingston, see kicking about the streets where I come from, it's a wee bit dodgy, and if you're shooting a video, you need honours, pal, I've got your back. Me and the HPYC and the HPYQ, we will be there all the time giving you honours, so nobody is going to mess with you, pal, so spot on, buddy.
Cruella, we're coming to you next. Did I see you tapping there during this rap? I've got a feeling, and by the way, can I say, Kingston wrote it himself. Wasn't that amazing? What do you think, Cruella?
Well, I may well have been tapping, but that was just to get to the end as quickly as possible. Skeggsy, little Skeggsy. You were talking about backing him up in the streets. Well, I think he should back down from this competition and do himself a favour. The only thing I thought was good about it was his walk. I thought he might be quite the dog walker for me. Give me a shout if you're looking for a job.
We're here with Jamie and Aidan. How long have you been playing football for?
Well, I've been playing for 10 years.
I've been playing for 10 as well.
Now I'm hearing it, there's a certain Glasgow football team that the manager needs a couple of strikers to try and keep his job. I wonder if Jamie and Aidan could be those. What do you think?
Well, Woody, I think it's not over until the fat lady sings. So I don't know who you're referring to. However, let's go back onto the football. Well, Elvis was the best thing about that, because a little less conversation and more action guaranteed is what I'm looking for in these football teams.
Champagne, you know all about movement. What did you think of the two boys' skills?
What do you actually think I'm stupid? Can tell that's no use. It's clearly fake. It's about as fake as Mr. Moran's degree for Glasgow Uni.
Now we're here with Mohammed Ahmed. How can you play so many songs on the piano?
It's just practice.
Thank you. message to all the mums and dads that are watching. See the next time you see your son or daughter on YouTube. Just think, they might, like Mohammed, be learning how to play the piano. What do you think of that? I thought it was amazing. But more important, let's go to our judges. Donald, who is still auditioning for Still Game. What do you think about Mohammed's playing?
Well, Claudia, I've left the streets of Glasgow University behind, and I've been kicking about the scheme with wee Skeggsy. And I've picked up some of the parlance, don't you know? So, I think that piano playing was heavy banging tunes.
What are you talking about?
Wonderful. And the fact that it was from off of the YouTubes, is that? Just remarkable.
Your Majesty, again, we've said this before, you have so many evenings, soirees, with all the top musicians and instrumentalists. What did you think about Mohammed?
What wonderful piano playing, Mohammed. Absolutely delightful to the ear. I've had a wonderful time here, and I'm sure, watching the show, Mrs. Bannerman up in music will be delighted to hear such talents. And apparently, you learned it all on the Yahoo-to-Hoob. That is absolutely outstanding. Well, I may be the queen, but in the words of the Queen of Christmas, not you, sorry, but Mariah Carey, all I want for Christmas is you on the piano while I'm carving the turkey. Well done. Oh, almost spilled the tea.
Well, everybody, you've seen all 18 acts this afternoon, and we just want to give them a huge, huge round of applause. But you know who else we want to thank? We want to thank Matthew and Jack for all their wonderful interviews. Let's hear it for the guys. Come on, louder than that. This wouldn't have been possible without six members behind us, six wonderful judges. So can you give a big round of applause for our judges here? Right. We've had a great time doing this, but now it's up to you. It's up to you to go into your email and get that link to do the votes. It's up to you to show your mums, your dads, your carers, your grannies, whoever you stay with, the link to Twitter, and they can go on and do the votes. Remember, you're voting from 3:15, check your time, until 2:15 on Monday. So let's all give these votes. Because you know, guys, it's been a horrible year. For many, many people, it's been very difficult. But today, I want to say to you, Happy Christmas, and I want you to end this show with our pupils and staff dancing around the Christmas tree, and please join them. Yeah!